Adam, when you first started acting, did you ever think, one day I really want to be attacked by a weird angel creature, some elves and a robot?
Yes. Yes, I did. Well, it's funny because growing up in the 80s, this is exactly the kind of movie that I used to go and see and wish I could be a part of, like Gremlins and Poltergeist and E.T. and these sort of family genre movies. So when Mike asked me to do it, I was really excited because I know that's what he wanted to do, is make one of those movies. And I've always wanted to be a part of one of those. And I don't feel like one has been made in years and years, you know?
It does feel very Amblin-y. There's the family aspect, then it becomes a horror and a creeper and an action movie.
Yeah.
Did you ever imagine that you'd get to do your Tom Cruise-y type moment, you know, gun up, being the hero?
It was really fun. Really fun to do that stuff. Loved it.
Is it kind of different to do that kind of stuff? I mean, obviously you've got comedy to begin with, but then you get into the real sort of action-y stuff.
Yeah.
We haven't seen you be in action for a little while.
Yeah. So. It was really, I love doing that stuff. I mean, Raiders of the Lost Ark is my favorite movie, so that is sort of what I love about the movies, is just kind of going to this extreme, complete other place.
Obviously, you and Dave Koechner, I think you have mutual friends, you've kind of worked in similar circles, but I don't think you've ever worked together screen together. So how much of a blast was it coming up with stuff with him?
It was great. And Dave, he's a great actor and a great improviser, and so it was really fun to kind of a kindred spirit on set.
Tony kind of told me that you had one scene, particularly in the dinner table, that seemed Mike just let it go on, and you guys were just swapping lines.
He just kind of let the cameras roll, and we must have gone on for like 10 minutes just making up ridiculous stuff, some of which is in the movie.
Is there going to be a good gag reel on this one? I get the feeling there might
be. I would imagine there would be, yeah.
What is it about Christmas that can be so scary? I mean, some of its most famous stories, Christmas Carol, are ghost stories, are spooky stories. Why is Christmas frightening?
Well, I think it's kind of weird. Like, there's a man in a big red suit who comes into your house in the middle of the night and eats your cookies and leaves presents. It's kind of an odd tradition. And so I think there's a real easy side door into a scary story there.
Is it also the fact that it's winter, the darkness has come in,
and
we're all kind of huddled together in the fire, avoiding the darkness?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. That's definitely part of it, yeah.
What was it like in New Zealand? I mean, it was shot in New Zealand, even though it's set in small town America. It's New Zealand. That seems like an amazing place to work.
It was terrific. It was really fun. Wellington is a beautiful, beautiful part of New Zealand, and had my kids and my wife with me, so it was really fun. Really, really fun.
The final question, Star Wars is back this year. It's huge.
Yeah.
If you had the chance, would you be in a Star Wars movie, and what would you want to play?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I think anyone who's sane would want to be in a Star Wars movie.
Yeah.
I'm so beyond excited to see this movie. I can't believe it's coming out. And I get to see the sequel to Return of the Jedi. So, I'm beyond excited to see it.